and fill our home with your presence. You alone are worthy of our reverence. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord.
Psalm 23, a Psalm of David.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Good morning to all of Grenada, to all of Karakou, Pirimoatling, those of you who are listening across the Caribbean and the world at large. Good morning. I am Pastor Stanford Simon. Welcome to Morning Glory. It is a joy and a pleasure to be with you. I'm excited about what God is going to do in your life today. I'm going to play some great music of worship and praise to God. And I know we're going to have a great and exciting time this morning as we give God thanks and praise for his goodness, his provision, and the wonderful opportunity you give to us to be here. Good morning to all the farmers who are waking up and making things happen, to all the bus drivers who are taking their folks to and from work today. Good morning to the security guards who have looked after us last night and begin their day. Thank you so much for being with us. And as we make our way to this day, we do not know what it holds, but I hope you know that God have allowed you to see another day, so make the best of it. And I want to say to you, you cannot rush excellence. You cannot rush excellence. And most of us, we rush through life, rush getting things, but you cannot rush excellence. It's beautiful to understand that when you take, God took time to get where he is with us. So take your time to get done what you need to get done. I talk about sculling now. I talk about pretending, you know, but to get it done right, you need to take your time to get it done right and good and proper. You know what I mean? Oh man, God is good. Good morning to you. Good morning. And special thanks to this station and to St. George's Baptist Church for making this program possible. I'm excited about it, and I have a lot in store to tell you as we go through this morning. I want to say good morning to you. I'm excited. Yeah, this was a good day, a really good day, and I thank God for his blessing. I thank God for the church I go to. It's a wonderful church, really, really wonderful, and I really enjoy being with the folks there. And, you know, just a love for God and a love for people, family, friendships, and relationships that we have built there. I just want to share this with the rest of the country. Building communities should become the model for winning people to Christ. That is the vision of the St. George's Baptist Church. And, you know, the mission, empowering people to enjoy prosperity and fulfillment in life. And I really want you to know that God loves you, and we at the St. George's Baptist Church, we love you dearly. May God bless you as we worship and praise God together. Welcome. Let us give God thanks. Father, we thank you for your provision, your love. We thank you for the wonderful opportunity you give us this morning. We just commit and dedicate ourselves to you. We hope the words that would be spoken and shared today would encourage hearts and bless us and bring us into a better relationship with you. This we ask in Jesus' holy and precious name. Amen and amen.
When peace like a river attendeth when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught.
My brethren, do not hold the faith of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory, with partiality. For if there should come into your assembly a man with gold rings and fine apparel, and there should also come in a poor man in filthy clothes, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say to him, "You sit here in a good place," and say to the poor man, "You stand there," or "Sit here at my footstool," have you not shown partiality among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my beloved brethren, has God not chosen the poor of this world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom which he promised to those who love him? But you have dishonored the poor man. Do not the rich oppress you and drag you into the courts? Do they not blaspheme that noble name by which you are called? If you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture, "You shall love your neighbor as yourself," you do well. But if you show partiality, you commit sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors. For whoever shall keep the whole law and yet stumble in one point, he is guilty of all. For he who said, "Do not commit adultery," also said, "Do not murder." Now, if you do not commit adultery, but you do murder, you have become a transgressor of the law. So speak and so do as those who will be judged by the law of liberty. For judgment is without mercy to the one who has shown no mercy. Mercy triumphs over judgment. What does it profit, my brethren, if someone says he has faith, but does not have works? Can faith save him? If a brother or sister is naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you says to them, "Depart in peace, be warmed and filled," but you do not give them the things which are needed for the body, what does it profit? Thus also faith by itself, if it does not have works, is dead. But someone will say, "You have faith and I have works. Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. You believe that there is one God. You do well. Even the demons believe and tremble. But do you want to know, O foolish man, that faith without works is dead? Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he offered Isaac his son on the altar? Do you see that faith was working together with his works, and by works faith was made perfect? And the scripture was fulfilled, which says, Abraham believed God, and it was accounted to him for righteousness, and he was called the friend of God. You see then that a man is justified by works, and not by faith only. Likewise, was not Rahab the harlot also justified by works when she received the messengers and sent them out another way? For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is dead also.
Life and life. have walked 1,000 miles through all my tests and all my trials, yeah. You still love me for me, and in the refuge of your wings I can rest in you safely, oh Lord. You covered me. Now I can finally see it was your love changing me. It's your mercy that draws me by your grace.
Thank you. Join us as we present real life and other uplifting stories to inspire you along the rugged paths of your life. Now, here is Pastor Stanford Simon.
Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 14 to 20. But I want to read one verse, verse 17. The Lord your God in your midst, the mighty one, will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing. Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 17. Just before Christmas one year, a friend was diagnosed with leukemia and was told she must begin chemotherapy immediately. Just a few weeks earlier, Kim had told friends how blessed and content she felt with a loving family, a comfortable home, and a new grandson. As she entered the hospital, Kim asked Jesus to make his presence known to her and to stay close. The next 7 months of treatment, followed by recovery in partial isolation because a season she called forced leisure, Kim said she learned how to slow down, reflect quietly, and rest in God's goodness, love, and perfect plan, regardless of whether or not she would be healed. One of God's promise to his people Israel became personal to Kim. The Lord your God will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing. Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 17. Kim is in remission after a journey she says changed her life for the better. Now, Kim is back to her busy routine. She often pauses to recapture the lessons of forced leisure. How important that we, in good times or times of challenges, draw near to God, loving heart, to hear his voice and placed our lives in his hand. Just thinking through all of this, and I thinking of the moments that we all going through now with COVID-19, where people need to think about their own life, their own relationship with God. With the difficult time we are confronted with, stay at home, lockdown, for a week, for 2 weeks, for 3 weeks, and some of us are grumbling and fumbling and finding ways to escape. The reality of it is, be thankful. Be thankful that God has given you a time to rejoice, a time to be glad, a time to be quiet, and a time for you to experience his love, that you can rejoice in his power. Look at what is happening in the world and think about your home now become your sanctuary. Why not enjoy the forced leisure time that you now have? I agree, I call it forced leisure time. It's beautiful. It's wonderful. I'm enjoying every bit of it. I get up in the morning and I do not have to think. I have to hustle out of the house to get to a meeting. I'd rather think about, look at my diary and said, you know, these meeting and that meeting, what I've canceled, what I've tried to get through in the day. No, not all of that. And where I'm tired and beat at the end of the day, I'm on my own time. My diary now is put aside. Set my schedule in the way that I want it to go. And I'm very sure that many of you out there are doing the same thing. You're feeling a sense of peace, restful, despite you have the bills to pay and the challenges or the mortgage to pay and money to buy food. All of that is there. But yet inside you have a sense of peace and comfort, and you are thankful for this moment just to do so many things in the house, or so many things you wanted to do for yourself you have not been able to do, or to spend time with the family that you've been longing for. It is here. So be thankful and enjoy your forced leisure time. Make the best of it Do it in style, within the beauty of your home and the confined space that the government has asked us to enjoy. Not we that force ourselves to enjoy it in COVID-19, and the government have so enforced it that we now have to obey it. Very interesting. Enjoy your forced leisure time today and give God thanks. Stop complaining and be thankful.
SGBC. A real home for the family, serving the community, providing guidance spiritually, and helping people connect socially.
So if you're feeling down, 'cause situations make you sad, you're free to come and let us praise the Lord, fulfilling the needs of humanity.
SGBC, where people's lives are transformed, communities are built up. No one is left behind.
Fulfilling the needs of humanity.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the
Pastor Stanford Simon for the young at heart. You are welcome. Challenging topics, hot debates, interesting things that you can learn from. The Bible says,
young men, I call you because you are strong. Make this your one and only first choice. Make this your last stop.
Till my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forever. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name.
could speak with the tongues of men and angels. But if I don't have love, I'm just a clanging cymbal. I could have the faith to remove the mountains. But if I don't have love, then I have love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is humble all of the time. Not easily angered, enduring the test. So never forget, love is the more excellent way. I could have the gift of prophecy, but if I don't have love, does it profit me? I could understand all mysteries, but if I don't have love, it's not enough to see. Love is patient.
First Corinthians chapter 13 there. Love is patient, love is kind. Read that chapter when you find a time today or before you leave the house. Try and read that chapter, it's very helpful. Love is the most excellent thing. You know, there are people who try to hurt us or do things to destroy us, and we want to get back and at them, and that's not the right thing. You need to kill them with love. I mean, pour love on them. The Bible says it is like putting the hot coals on their head, and that is what you want to do. That's what God did for us. Do you know, we were banished and doomed for hell, and he sent his only begotten son that we can have eternal life. That's the beauty of this relationship. And so I am confident that God is going to take us through it, and we are going to do a great and excellent work in all that we do. I am confident that God wants to do a work in your life, and I'm confident that he is going to take you from where you are to carry you to where you are to be. Isn't God a wonderful God? Indeed he is. There is none like unto him in all the earth, and I'm very sure that God will never leave us, nor will he forsake us. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we commit ourselves to you today, Lord. We thank you for your blessings, your provision. Thank you for our home. Thank you for our family. Thank you for the people you have brought into our lives and how you continue to use us to become an instrument of change. I bring, God, every worker, every vehicle, every manager, Lord, every supervisor before you today. Lord, I just cover every bus driver, Lord, every pedestrian today. Just look over them. May they seek your face, your leadership, and your guidance, Lord. For those who are visiting our land, we pray for them today that you look over them. We pray for our families, Lord, that is struggling so much. There's so much difficult things happening across our land. There's so many families without food, without money to take care, Lord, of themselves, of their children. God, there's so many people cannot pay their mortgage, cannot buy food to put on the table. But Lord, I know that you provide. We pray for wisdom for leaders across this land, our prime minister, our ministers of government. God, give them clarity of vision and direction, God, that we can find a way to ensure that our people succeed. I know your word said you'll never leave us, nor will you forsake us, and we're confident today that you would look after us. Even though, Lord, we have absolutely nothing, we will not steal, oh God, we'll not lie to get things. We will do what is right today to do it. I pray, oh God, for those who are planning to lie or to steal, those who are planning to do something wrong or to say something, Lord, to destroy the life of someone, I pray today they would do something different, because your word would speak to them deep, personal, Lord, intimately, that they would be drawn to you, God, and leave the past behind and so hold on to the future. I just surrender myself to you as I surrender each person that is listening, God, that their life would be blessed today. They would receive a miracle from you. They'll receive something unique that they have never received before. And Lord, they would see your glory and your honor shining round about them and their family. So we just claim your victory today. We claim it for our children. We cover them in the blood of the Lamb. The enemy is a liar. The devil is a liar. He will not defeat our children. He will not defeat our young people, God. Today we rejoice in them because they are unique and special. They are precious, Lord, in your sight. And so they are precious to us. We ask your blessing upon each of our families, O God, today. Look after them in a special way. In Jesus' holy and precious name, amen and amen. And all of God's people here on Morning Glory say amen. God bless you. Have a great day.
You feel like giving up now. Your spot is tough now. But how can you learn if you don't fall? How can you walk if first you don't crawl? But through it all, you keep blessing me while they pressing me and they testing me. They keep stressing me because they never heard a preacher flow. Show, go, no.
come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. Music for the weary and burdened. That's SGBC. If you're listening, you know you'll never be the same.
Your love is amazing, steady and unchanging. Your love is a mountain firm beneath my feet. Your love is a mystery, how you gently lift me. When I am surrounded, your love carries me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing and hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing. Your love is surprising, I can feel it rising. All the joy that's growing deep inside of me. And every time I see you, all your goodness shines through. And I can feel this God song rising up in me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing and hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing. Your love is amazing, steady and unchanging. Your love is a mountain firm beneath my feet. Your love is a mystery, how you gently lift me. When I am surrounded, your love carries me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing and hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing. Yes, you make me sing. Lord, you make me sing, sing, sing. How you make me sing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your love and your peace and your joy. Thank you for the opportunity you have given to us to see this new day. We pray for a blessing over us. We think about the people of Ukraine, O God, what they're going through, the agony and pain for which this world is confronted with. We do not know the future, but we lay ourselves in your hand. We pray for the guidance and leadership, Lord, over our children, over our homes, over our family. Lord, over every vehicle that will be traveling on the road, for those who will be traveling. We pray for those who are in pain and agony this morning. We pray for those who are on the verge of death and do not know you as Lord God, they would surrender to you. We pray, Almighty God, that you have mercy on them. Have mercy upon us, Heavenly Father, who have not yet trusted you, and for many, God, who are longing to have a relationship with you, Lord, but cannot commit to that relationship. We pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, you draw them into a closer relationship with you. And we give a prayer, asking you, Lord, to bless, to secure, and to guide us into the path of righteousness.
As I shall live, I will testify. promises when the words are not enough. With every breath I take, we'll give thanks to God above. For as long as I shall live, I will testify.
Good morning, Grenada. As long as I live, I will testify of the love of God, the peace of God, the joy of God. It is in abundance for those who want it. Come unto me, all you are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believe on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. I believe in him, and I'll testify continually of the joy, the peace, and the abundance of his love he pour over me day after day. It's available to you, to your family, and to everyone. Come join us at the St. George's Baptist Church as we continue to worship and give God praise. We are preparing for the children. Yeah, they will be here every second and fourth Saturday from 10 to 1. I know you parents have a lot to do. I know there's a lot going on. You have all these classes you have to send them. But listen, taking one Saturday out, even one, and just sending your children at the St. George's Baptist Church between the age of 5 and 16, they're willing to work with them. There are persons available there to make things happen. So make it happen. Make it happen for them. And don't forget, remember, save the date. It is on the 31st of December, Holiest Night Service at St. George's Baptist Church. We're excited and looking forward to having it there in the Springs Plain Field. Thank you, everyone, for being with me, for the peace that God brings to us and through us as we surrender to him. I love my God. I know, we all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, but he gave his only begotten Son that you can have eternal life. I'm Pastor Stanford Simon. Thank you so much for listening. Know that your dream killers are there. If they will do everything possible to destroy you or your dreams, do not allow them to. Hold your head up, your shoulder up, go out there, do and be the best you can. Know that I love you, but my God love you far more. Hey, I'm signing out of this beautiful country, wonderful place called Grenada. There's no place like home. Hey, have a blessed day. With all the rain falling, and it's hot, man. You know, it's like you're hot today and, you know, rain tomorrow, whatever. But we thank God for the rain, and we thank him for the sun. Let's go out there and just be the best we can.